Hello everyone, in this video we are going to do the practice of dimensioning. For all these topics, what is dimensioning, why it is required, what are the elements of dimensioning, system of dimensioning, type or method of dimensioning, dimensioning of circles, angles and rule of dimensioning, you can go to my previous video. In this video we have to do the practice how we can make the perfect dimensioning. Now for this purpose I have taken the topic, that is system of dimensioning. I will make a diagram and I will show you how to do the dimensioning. Now we know that what are the system of dimensioning. There are two system of dimensioning. First is aligned system and second is unidirectional system. Now I have drawn one diagram to represent the aligned system. Now what is this actually? This is the diagram which I have drawn with the continuous thick line. This is the shape of main object. So when we make an object, it will have a continuous thick lines, and it is also having one other type of line that is known as center line, just to represent the center of the circle, one long, one short line. I have discussed it with you in last video. Now what is the correct way to do dimensioning of this? Now we know the elements of dimensioning. These all are the elements of dimensioning. Now we have to take care about each and every element. Same here, we have the object line with continuous thick line. We want to give dimension of this to this edge. What is the first element? You have to draw the extension line. Now extension line will have 2 mm gap in this side. So put the scale here and exactly measure 2 mm gap. The main purpose is it should not touch the object line. Draw very light line, just touch it on the sheet and give direction. Do not put force on the pencil. Same here, 2 mm gap and very light line, just touch on the sheet and give direction only. These extension lines should be continuous thin line. After that we have to draw the dimension line. Now dimension line should be at the gap of at least 10 mm. So from this you have to take approximate 10 mm gap. When you are doing the practice of dimensioning, in those cases you have to measure these distances. Otherwise when you will be confident enough, then you have no need to measure all these distances. So with practice you can do it very easily. So these are our two elements, extension line and dimension line. Extension line is telling you the limit from which point to which point you are making the dimension, and it should not touch the object, main object, because otherwise it will change the shape of object, and all these lines should be very thin and very light. Now the next element we have to say, that is the arrowhead. So how to draw the arrowhead? We know that it should be 3:1, so very thin, long in length, less in width. The tip of the arrowhead must be on the extension line. This is the way to draw the arrowheads. I will do the dimensioning of aligned system later on, just to tell you the difference with the unidirectional also. Now we want to give the dimension from this to this. Now here you can see there is an arc. Now how to do the dimensioning here? Again, take 1-2 mm gap for extension lines, very light line, thin line. Now from the straight part you have to take again 2 mm and then very thin line. Got this point? Then again you have to take 10 mm gap in between the object line and dimension line. In between the object line and dimension line, 10 mm gap. Now the arrowheads are required, so you have to draw the arrowheads like this. Again 3:1, 3 units of length, 1 unit of width. Done. Now we have to do the dimensioning of this part. Take 2 mm gap here, draw the extension line, very light line, 2 mm gap here, take extension line, very light line. Now what should be the length of these extension line? We draw the extension line so that it should cross the dimension line. If we have a number of dimension lines, we have to use a long extension line. Now in this way also, again I'm not measuring again and again 10 mm because with practice I know that what is the 10 mm distance. Again very light line, thin line, having arrowheads, tip on the extension line like this. Now we have this inclined edge. How to do the dimensioning of this inclined edge? Now these extension lines should be perpendicular to the object line always. So these are the properties. For all these properties you can refer my last video. After this again 10 mm gap. Hold your scale parallel to the object line, because dimension line must be parallel to object line. Now the arrowheads, very thin arrowhead, more in length, less in width. Now how to do dimensioning of a circle? There are four methods to give dimension to a circle. That I have also described in that video. So take the leader line. It should be towards the midpoint from outside of the circle like this. From outside you have to bend this dimension line, then it is known as leader line, a dimension line with bend. I am representing one way of circle only, so there are few other ways also. It depends where is the circle, right? And this is leader line. Now how to do dimensioning of an arc? There are again two ways to do dimensioning, from outside or from inside. So I am showing you one method. From outside you can give dimension in this way. It will have only a leader line with one arrow, and tip of the arrow must be on the arc. Now remember this, all these dimension elements, these should not be dark, and you have to draw exactly the same arrowhead. Try to draw. When you will do practice for 10-15 arrowheads, then you will be perfect in this. Now this is the aligned system. Same we will do the dimensioning of unidirectional system. The difference starts when we have to write the numeral value. Now we will see what is the difference between aligned and unidirectional. In aligned system you have to remember the two rules. The dimension value, let's say any value is there, dimension value must be always above the dimension line. This is first rule. Second, the dimension value should be readable from downward or from right hand side direction. Now what are these rules? We will see. Now let's say this length is 70. Now how to write 70? First rule, above the dimension line. So this is dimension line, above the dimension line we write the value. Now this 70, it is readable from downward direction and it is in the mid of this dimension line. Same, let's say this is the length and we have drawn it equals to approximate 35. So above dimension line, means we have to write here the value, and readable from downward. Downward means if we have to write 70, this is readable from downward. When I say readable from right side, so this is readable from right side. It means where to write this thing, where to write. Both we can use in a line system. It depends in the direction. So this is 35. We use the same letter writing style. You know how to write the numerals. Use the same. Now this was 60, let's say. Now to write the numerals in the vertical dimension, we have to use the right side. Now from this side we can read the value, because if I write the value from this side, I cannot say this is above or this is above dimension line. So prefer the right side. So in the right side we again use the letter proper numeral style, and I have given the value here. Then for inclined, it is again perpendicular to that dimension line. So let's say this is 40, so above dimension line and exactly perpendicular to the dimension line. Then let's say this is 30, right? And for this circle, dimensioning of circle, we have drawn the leader line, and above that leader line as this is the aligned system. So above the leader line we represent it with 5. 5 stands for diameter. Now this is the circle of 20 diameter. For all the circles we always give diameter, and for this arc where we have drawn this line, and you have to write R. This is the arc of radius 4, so we represent it with R4. R stands for radius here. Now in unidirectional system, so this is the aligned system. Now what will be there in unidirectional? Unidirectional says that the dimension value, here the dimension value is above the dimension line, but in a unidirectional system this dimension value will be in between the dimension line. Second, as the name says that uni means single, so we will use only downward direction, not the right side also, only downward, uni only downward direction. So let's see how to do dimensioning in unidirectional system. Now this was 70, so in between dimension line I'm writing 70 readable from downward. This was 35, in between dimension line I'm writing 35, in between dimension line readable from downward. For this also, you can see how I have written 60 here, above dimension line readable from right side, here in between dimension line readable from downward. So this is the way how to write dimension with unidirectional system. Same here, this is 30, and same for inclined part, readable from downward, exactly vertical. Now for the arcs, so in between the leader line we write, this was of diameter 20, so in between the leader line we write readable from downward. So this is the way how we differentiate between aligned and unidirectional. And whenever you have to give the dimensions, either go for aligned or unidirectional. You cannot use both. You have to select a single dimension system. Thank you.